Hello, I'm Bishop Michael Olson, and I am the Bishop of the Catholic Diocese of Fort Worth, Texas. The Catholic Diocese of Fort Worth, Texas includes over 1 million self-identified Catholics in a 28-county geographical area in North Texas. There are over 90 parishes and 19 schools, and with a very diverse population that include people in rural areas, urban areas, and suburban areas. It includes college campuses, it includes older communities, it includes people who speak Spanish as their primary language, Vietnamese as their primary language, Twi among the Ghanaian Catholic community, Korean, as well as English. We are a diverse Catholic population that makes known the diversity and the richness of the people of God. This January, I will mark 5 years as your bishop. During these 5 years, I have been entrusted to you as your bishop to oversee and to care for you pastorally. I have always made it a priority to provide a safe environment for you and to uphold the standards necessary for a clergy that will give you pastoral care that you can trust. This has been a priority that my priests have gladly embraced and accepted, and that I am very happy to continue to provide. With such a large population, any decision that I make as bishop will undoubtedly disappoint some people, make them unhappy, or not be fully understood. That is the nature of my ministry as the Bishop of the Diocese of Fort Worth. I understand this, and I count on you to take that to prayer as I take it to prayer. I want to assure you that every decision I make, I take with due consultation among those who are affected by the decisions, and I make them with the best interest of those involved and for the common good of the faith and the safe environment and pastoral care of the entire people of God. It's impossible to make everybody happy by a decision I make. A handful of unhappy Catholic people have taken it upon themselves to institute a social media campaign and a political campaign based on their disappointment and unhappiness to discredit me and my ministry and leadership as your bishop in the Diocese of Fort Worth. I wish to address some of the issues that have brought doubt and concerns among you that they have raised in order that I might bring clarity to the reality of the situation. First of all, the FRK advocates have attempted to connect the decisions made by two diocesan priests, Father Gary Piku and Father Jeff Perot, to leave the active ministry as being my decision. They have made these decisions on their own and after their own discernment, in no way connected to my decision. Secondly, the FRK advocates have attempted to categorize the recent decisions regarding San Mateo Mission of St. Patrick Cathedral as an example of me not following canonical procedures. That is not true. San Mateo Mission was never a parish, and while it is a church, it is a chapel or a mission of St. Patrick's Cathedral. The parishioners of St. Patrick's Cathedral who had attended San Mateo Mission, who were upset with my decision, had their recourse with Rome before the Congregation for Clergy. The Congregation for Clergy heard their case and rejected their recourse and upheld my decision and understanding of San Mateo as not being a parish in itself. The point being is they do have access to the canonical process, and I respect their right to it. And the Holy See upheld my decision. I am looking forward to a peaceful reconciling so that we can go forward as a parish community and a diocesan community. Thirdly, the issue of the removal of Father Genaro Mayorga as pastor of All Saints Catholic Church in Fort Worth. It came to my attention by Fort Worth police officers that Father had been cited in a public park at 2 a.m. for assault. And that assault included the touching of a man in a private area. It was reported by the man, and it was confirmed and written up as a citation by our Fort Worth police officers. The Fort Worth police officers asked to meet with me. I personally met with them and heard of their concerns and also saw the police report. On that judgment, I contacted the religious superior of Father Mayorga, and I asked that he be returned to his community for pastoral care for the good of all involved. That is the truth. I followed the procedures that are appropriate to a bishop and a religious community, that religious order priests serve at the discretion of the local bishop for the common good of the diocese and the entire church. Fourthly, the FRK advocates have raised concerns regarding the resignation of the office of pastor by Father Richard Kirkham at St. Martin de Porres Catholic Church and the circumstances surrounding his decision to resign and my decision to ask for his resignation. In May, I received a letter from the Bishop of Dallas that one of his priests had presented to him that had been written by Father Richard Kirkham. The letter was perceived by the priest who received it as intimidating and as manipulative. I read the letter and shared the opinion that it was lewd and threatening, and that it was not befitting of a priest to have written it. He admitted to me and to others that he wrote the letter. He admitted to me and to others that he never intended to report sexual misconduct or predatory behavior in the workplace against the priest who received the letter. He admitted to me and to others that he wrote the letter to obtain the attention from this other priest who had ceased contact with him. The notion that he is somehow a whistleblower of misconduct who is being punished for attempting to bring to light the sexual misconduct of another priest is just simply untrue. Father Kirkham and I met regarding this letter in June of 2018. In the letter, which he admits to writing, he claims that he has known about this alleged sexual misconduct and predatory behavior against a vulnerable adult since October of 2017. In all that time, Father Kirkham failed to report it to the Diocese of Dallas. He failed to come to the Bishop of Dallas regarding this alleged misbehavior of a priest of the Diocese of Dallas, and he failed to come to me as his own bishop. All of these things, inclusive with the writing of the letter itself and other matters which he drew to my attention, prompted me to ask him for his resignation as the pastor of St. Martin de Porres in Prosper, which I did so out of concern for him as his bishop and for the people of God of the parish of St. Martin de Porres. I ask you, in conclusion, to pray for all people involved in these matters. I ask you to pray for me as your bishop. I ask you to pray for our priests during this challenging time. I also ask you to take note of all of the good things that happen in our local church of the Diocese of Fort Worth. I ask you to be vigilant in your care for your families during this Advent season and into Christmas, and I ask you especially for your support and ongoing prayers as your bishop. Thank you.